Assalamualaikum, dear students of class 3. How are you all? Hope you all are enjoying at home. I know it is very tough to stay at home, but still what to do? Due to coronavirus, we have to be safe at home. So please stay safe at home and do not waste your time, but use your time in studying. Yesterday I took your Bangla class. Hope you all enjoyed that. In YouTube, if you just write down search Oxbridge English School, then you will get all the subjects we have done and uploaded in YouTube. So today I will take your science class, elementary science. So this is your book. I'm opening the book. Open your book. Chapter 6, you all have done in your school till chapter 5. So today I will try to make you understand of about chapter 6. Have you opened the book? Yeah. You see, this the chapter is quite big, and if I start reading and explaining every line, it will take enough time. So in YouTube, to make it shorter, I will just tell you the summary of this year. I will try to tell you, because if you read the chapter, it is so simple that you can understand everything. And whatever words are hard and new for you, I have marked with red pen, you see. So this the words which are a little bit hard for you, I have marked with red pen. So let me tell you about air. Air, there is a vast layer of air around the earth, you know, air around us. So there is a air among the particles of soil as well. In the air, there are lots of particles of soil and other components. Air is a mixture which is made up of various type of gases. Air is a gas, you know, but there are a lot more gas in the air. So now today we will give you a little bit idea about what type of gases are there in the air. And then mainly it contains nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc. There are also dust and other gases in air. We take oxygen from air through breathing. We cannot make the fire without oxygen. That means, to protect the existence of life on the earth, there is no alternative to oxygen. We need oxygen to live in this earth. Even plants need carbon dioxide for producing food. The fertilizer, you know, fertilizer that we use for cultivation, that containing nitrogen makes plants grow well. Beside, air is used to move the sailboat and to fill up tires of bicycles and cars and so many other things. So this is a summary of the air. So if you read the full book, you will get these important points. These are the thing you will feel: the presence of air. You will know components of air, what are the components and use of air, how we use gas in the air in daily life, how we can prevent the air pollution. So if you read, you see, air is a component of natural environment, plants and animals. Air to survive. What is air? Why do we need air? So this is how you have to read. And when you will see the underlined verdicts, I am just reading the word which you have to memorize. Once let me read it and you note it in your copy. Survive. Air around us, surrounded. And all these things are very simple, you can understand. So here, release. And then from summary, situation. And from discussion part, essential. And from use of air, wind turbines. I am giving you the accurate pronunciation also. and then incense, burning in here, incense. Then nothing difficult here, record your observations, and then from discussion you have to read these questions and discuss with your mother or your brother, sisters or your father. Here it is written that share your ideas with your classmates. So you don't have classmate now, or you can talk with them over phone or discuss with your parents. And in summary, you know what is oxygen? A gas in the air that can help something to burn is called oxygen. And then carbon dioxide cannot help something to burn. So these are some practical things you have to do at home. If you get interest, you read it and do the activity at home. And here, nitrogen gas. There are nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide and water vapor in the air. I am making it short to make the lesson shortened. Then uses of gas in air. So where we use the oxygen for breathing and for the plant. You see here is a picture of a plant that carbon dioxide is coming, taking from the air. Leaves are taking carbon dioxide from the air. This arrow means it is going in the leaf to make food. And it is releasing oxygen, and that oxygen we human being and all other living things take to survive. So the plant is giving off oxygen, and you see the patients, they are receiving extra oxygen through masks. Nowadays in COVID-19, the main reason of their difficulty is breathing problem. So we are giving them ventilator and extra oxygen. So you know now in the news, if you go see watch TV, and you will get this term again and again. And in soft drink, we use carbon dioxide, is you also used in fire extinguisher. You see fire extinguisher, why we use fire extinguisher? To help the fire not to burn. I'm telling you in the okay, so it's becoming a little hazy, but it will be fixed. And then you see the mobile focus is a little, now it's okay. How to have nitrogen, where we use nitrogen? Nitrogen is used in preserving food such as a bag of potato chips. It is also used in making light bulbs. So you see the potato, bag of potato and fertilizer. So now you know three oxygens, three gas in the air, oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen. You have to read the full thing and you will understand that what are these and where we do use it. And then you discuss how do we use air in our daily life, make a list and do at home. Then air pollution. I know that you all have done debates about air pollution. You have enough idea, but still read this and what I have marked here. Odor, respiratory, causes of air pollution, variety of sources, and then contributes. And here, emission of black smoke. So emission means coming out. Black smokes come out from the car. So these are the few hard words for you. Others are very simple. So you will see all these things, read every line and then come to the exercise. For exercise, once you finish reading the full chapter, you can easily do the exercise. Let me tell you, like filling the blanks. Black dash from car causes air pollution. Black what? Smoke. In an electric bulb, nitrogen gas is used. To stop fire, carbon gas is used. And then dash is used to fill out tires of cars. Oxygen. Walking or riding a bike can help prevent what? Air pollution. And then you read it and tick mark the correct answer. And here you see answered the following question. I have written the answer for you so that you can learn it. And then finally, what you will do, match the words on the left with the related words on the right. It is very easy. You can easily do. So let me show you what I have written for you. The question answer. The first question is, class 3, science, chapter 6, year, today's date is 3/5/20. First question is, give 3 examples to prove that air is around us. See, number 1 answer, we feel air when we use a hand fan. Number 2, branches and leaves of trees move. Number 3, sailboat moves across the water. So these are the 3 examples to prove that air is around us. Question number 2, name 4 components of air. Component means what are inside the air. Answer, the name of 4 components of air are oxygen gas, nitrogen gas, carbon dioxide gas and water vapor. All these things are the components of air. Question number 3. Describe 3 ways to prevent air pollution. So, there are a lot of ways to prevent air pollution, but here we are giving only 3 ways. 3 ways to prevent air pollution are A. Walking or riding a bike cycle helps to prevent air pollution. If you avoid car, any motor car, so to stop the black smoke, so you can prevent air pollution. Number B, reducing waste or garbage can prevent air pollution. That means if you do not increase the waste, that reduce the waste, then air, there is good air condition. Number C, stopping the emission coming out. Emission means coming out. So stopping the emission of black smoke from cars and factories. So if we do these 3 things, follow these 3 things, we can prevent air pollution. So what is today's homework? You see, this is your today's homework. Read full chapter. Every line you have to read. Number 2, write meaning of marked words. Marked words mean what I have underlined with red pen. Only write the meaning from the dictionary. And it should be English to English meaning. Number 3, learn and write the above 3 questions. These 3 questions I have given to you to learn, memorize and write in your copy, note copy. Number 4, question number 4 of the exercise. That is what? Do not match this one. You see? Number 4, match the words. You have to do it by yourself. Once you read the full chapter, you can easily do the exercise. So this is your today's homework from elementary science. Thank you.